Legos. We all know them as those simple building blocks we played with as children. Well, believe it or not, the LEGO Group, the company who makes these, has actually come a long way since then. What you just witnessed was their latest creation, which is called LEGO Mindstorms NXT. It's actually a robotics kit which allows you to build such things as this car here that can drive all by itself without anybody's help at all. The purpose of this video is to give you a brief overview of what is LEGO Mindstorms NXT. I'll show you what's included with this kit, how to build a simple robot, how to program that robot to do what you want it to do, and finally, how to test run that robot to make sure it works. As you can see, the NXT kit comes with a wide variety of items. It comes with plenty of pieces, which consist of beams, axle rods and axle connectors, an assortment of small beam and axle connectors, a wide variety of gears, your primary connectors, some miscellaneous items, and finally, the electronics. The kit also comes with a user guide and quick start guide, a large fold-out test pad, and software for programming your robots, of which I'll walk you through later on. I will now give you a closer look at the electronics included with the NXT kit. These pieces are what essentially make this a robotics kit and distinguishes it from any other LEGO products. First, there's the NXT brick, which is the brain of any NXT robot. It's a small 32-bit computing device complete with ports for input sensors, output ports, and USB. It also has user input buttons, an LCD display screen, built-in memory for storing files and programs, Bluetooth connectivity, and an internal loudspeaker for audio output. It requires 6 AA batteries or an optional rechargeable battery pack to function, but neither of these are included with the kit. Next are the 4 input sensors, which allow an NXT robot to become aware of its surroundings. For the following demonstrations, I've hooked the sensor up to one of the NXT brick's sensor ports using the provided cable. In the corner of the screen, you can see the NXT display, which is outputting the current reading for that sensor. First, I'll demonstrate the touch sensor, which can distinguish between a state of being pressed, released, or bumped. Next, I'll demonstrate the sound sensor, which can measure sound intensity in decibels. I'll use my cell phone to ring next to the microphone so you can see it change. I'll now demonstrate the light sensor, which can measure ambient lighting given a room's light intensity. The light sensor can also be used to measure reflected light, which can measure how light or dark a surface is. And if you really try, you can see that it changes as you select different colors throughout the color spectrum. It'll vary, but it's not exact. Finally, there's the ultrasonic sensor, which can measure how close it is to something, such as my hand, or even the camera that's filming this right now, which appears to be about 27 inches away. The NXT kit also comes with 3 output motors. These are what enables an NXT robot to move. For the following demonstration, I've hooked a motor up to one of the output ports on the NXT brick using the same type of cable that you use for the input ports. A motor can turn in either direction at a user-specified speed for a set amount of time, such as 3 seconds, a set number of rotations, such as 2 rotations, or a set number of degrees, such as 90 degrees. When building a LEGO Mindstorms NXT robot, you're really only limited by your imagination. While the kit only comes with a certain number of pieces, you can still build something really cool with the ones provided. If you decide you need more, you can always go and buy them off the internet or at a store. When building something new, you usually spend a long time just experimenting with all kinds of new different designs. And while this is really fun, it can take forever sometimes. And with that in mind, I'd like to show you how to build a simple robot using the provided manual that comes with the kit. This is actually a quick start guide that walks you through step by step how to build one of your first robots. It's actually a very simple process. All you have to do is follow a series of ordered steps that are shown in the manual. For each step, you're given a picture and a quantity of each piece that will be needed. Simply assemble the pieces as shown, and you'll have a finished robot in no time. I'll go ahead and finish this one now. Well, that wasn't so bad, now was it? The NXT robot that I just built didn't include any instructions for an input sensor. Because of this, I'm going to add this ultrasonic sensor onto the front of it that we'll then be able to use whenever we program it.